Welcome back to a second video on how to solve a given problem. This time we'll solve the problem using the TI84 graphing calculator. A company has a policy of retiring company cars. This policy looks at the number of miles driven, purpose of trips, style of car and other features, the distribution of the number of months in service for the fleet of cars is bell shape, which means we have a normal distribution, the mean is 39 months, and a standard deviation is 5 months. So we know that mu, the mean, equals 39, and sigma, the standard deviation, is equal to 5. We're asked to use the 68-95-99.7 rule, or empirical rule, but in this example we'll be using the T84 to determine the approximate percent of cars that remain in service between 44 and 54 months. So if we let x be equal to the number of months, we want to determine the percent or probability that x is, again, between 44 and 54, x would be greater than 44 and less than 54. This is really all we need in order to determine this percent on the T84, though we'll also take a look at how to find this percentage using z-scores after we look at this first method. So now we'll go to the calculator. We press second vars for the distribution menu. We want option 2, normal CDF. Now if you don't see this screen, don't panic. That means you have the older 84 or the 83. So after we complete this screen, I'll show you what you would need to do. But on this screen, the first thing we do is enter the lower x value, which is 44. So 44, enter. The upper x value is 54, so 54, enter. Mu, the mean, is 39, so 39, enter. Sigma, the standard deviation, is 5. So 5, enter, and when the cursor is on paste, we press enter. And if you did not have the previous screen, once you select normal CDF, it shows up on the home screen, like you see here, and what you would have to do is enter 44, 54, 39, 5, which again is the lower x value, upper x value, mean, and standard deviation. On this newer version, the previous screen just helps enter these four values. So now we press enter and it gives us the percent as a decimal. As a decimal, this would be approximately 0.1573, which as a percent would be 15.73%, which means approximately 15.73% of the cars remain in service between 44 and 54 months. Now I do want to mention that when we did this by hand using the empirical rule, our percent was a little bit different because the calculator is giving us a little bit more of an accurate percentage. When we did this by hand using the empirical rule, we came up with 15.85%. But our homework system is set up to accept both percentages. Now a second approach to the same problem would be to use z-scores. Let's also show that method. Remember, z-scores indicate how far a given data value is away from the mean, where the z-score is equal to x minus mu divided by sigma. So as an alternative approach, let's calculate the z-score for x equals 44 and for x equals 54. So for x equals 44, we would have 44 minus 39, the mean, divided by 5, which would be 5 divided by 5, which equals 1. Which means 44 is one standard deviation above the mean. And then for 54, we'd have a z-score of 54 minus 39 divided by 5, which is equal to 15 divided by 5, which equals 3, which means 54 is 3 standard deviations above the mean. So making the connection here, the percent or probability that x is greater than 44 and less than 54 is the same as the percent or probability that the z-score is greater than 1 and less than 3. And we can also determine this percent on the graphing calculator using the z-score, as long as you remember that when we're talking about z-scores or the standard normal distribution, mu is equal to 0 and sigma is equal to 1. So going back to the calculator, once again, we'll press second vars for distribution, option 2. And now for the lower value here, it's going to be the lower z-score of 1. Enter. The upper value is going to be the z-score of 3. Enter. So because these are z-scores, we know that mu, the mean, must be 0, and sigma, the standard deviation, must be 1. And we press enter on paste. And again, if you have the older 84 or 83, you do have to enter 1, 3, 0, 1, and enter. And notice how we get the same decimal, and therefore the same percentage. 0.1573, which would be 15.73%. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.